Hello and welcome to lesson 25. In this lesson, we'll go over the spec finder and the align options. Let's start. First, we'll draw a couple of basic shapes. You can also, you can make the shape, but if you press Option or Alt, and you can draw from that point instead of down or up. So let's make different colors for this. So we see what's going on. And we select them all and place them here. Now let's go to the Pathfinder and see what those things do. Now for every shape, you got two options. We'll make a copy of one here. One option is to a destructive mode. And as you see, they unites the pads. The other mode is to press Alt or Option. As you see, it makes a compound path. A compound path is a path made of multiple shapes. And so now, can right click and select isolate, select a group. Also, if you didn't change any settings in your preferences, you can double click to edit and isolate. So now you can move both objects and change the position. So if you click back, you get a new shape. It's similar to grouping if you want. Okay, we got the idea of this one, and they can be used for all those four on track called shape modes. The next one is called minus front, and if an object is front, you can right click, go to arrange, and bring to front, back, backward, or forward. Unlike Photoshop, which uses a different layer for every object, you can use one layer for multiple objects. And the order does matter. So if you say minus front, the object in front will cut out the object in back. Now, the opposite is minus back in Pathfinders, and will cut down the other shape. Since this one, the green one, is in back, as you can see here. You will go over the layers later. Now, the next thing we want to do is intersect. This is pretty simple. It will delete all the shapes that do not have a common area. So this one and this one. And all these main is the one in center. Again, you can Alt or Option click. And the shapes will be preserved. And if you click Expand, the process will be destructive and you get the final result. The last one is called exclude, and it works similar to intersect, but it deletes the common area. Then we move to Pathfinders. Those are destructive. You cannot make compound paths of them. Now let's see the first one. It's called divide, and this one will cut every object out. Let's click it. And right click and click ungroup. So we got this one and this one and this one. Oops, we got an apple here. Wonder why, where that comes from. Anyone has an iPhone? Okay, let's move on. Now we got both shapes again. You can press Ctrl or Command Z to undo, like I am doing. If you wonder how I'm reverting, you can use trim, and this will basically unite the shapes in front and the ones that intersect. See, the one is cut and this one is full. We can move to this one, and now you can use merge. which is similar to unite. Then we have a crop, which is similar to minor intersect, but it leaves out the shape in front. Then we have outline, which makes an outline of the object, and minus front, I already showed you what it does. Okay, this is for the Pathfinder. It's similar in action to the shape builder tool, but you have some more options. The quick way is the shape builder tool, but if you have many objects, it's better use the Pathfinder. Okay, let's delete those because we don't need them, and let's make a couple of basic circles. And let's change some colors here, so we know what we are dealing with. We'll make another copies, and we'll change more colors. Okay, now let's see what we can align here. The first option is to align horizontal left. Be mindful that we have three options here. Align to selection, which is aligns to whatever we have selected, which is the bounding box in this case. Then we have a key object, which can align to a certain object. And then we have artboard, which aligns to the entire artboard, which is the margins here. So if we have the artboard and we click horizontal line left, it will move everything to the left. In order to prevent everything to overlapping, you group them. You press Ctrl or Command J. So if you press again, it will move everything. In order to ungroup, you press Command or Ctrl Shift G. Or just right click and choose the option. Okay, then we can simply use Align to Selection and Horizontal Align Center. It's better if we move them a little so they are not so perfect. So if you select this one, again, align center, and align center. Same for this, you can press and it'll move everything to the most left or right object, in this case left. Then you have vertical line top, center, and bottom. So let's try to make this grid perfect again. Okay, this works. Now you got two other options. So we'll move this a little. Actually, that's good. Then we have distribute objects. You can vertically, top, and so on. Can also choose those, for example, and it will make them equal spaces between them. Same for those. Now you got this 2-bit spacing, which is a very nice method. Works with align to key object only. So you select a key object and the highlight will be around this object or whatever you have selected, but you can just click inside the selected group and you select another key object. And you can increase spacing. If you don't remember, if you press Shift, you increase by 10 increments. Then you press Horizontal Distribute Center, and you can quickly align map. Same for vertical. And that's how it works. Okay. One other thing, you should be aware that you can also align points. So we have something like this. We can select the points with the direct selection tool and align them. So the align tool isn't limited to entire objects, but can be used in other points as well. Okay, this is for this lesson, and see you in the next one. Thank you.